Hello again. So on with chords. Right. So far we've been looking at giving notes. So things like this. I keep typing cafe for some reason. I'm missing my favorite cafes at the moment. And I think it's also French for coffee, which I could also do with. So chords work similarly to this. You can just put it in the mini notation. So let's have a look at what numbers that gives. So if I just put this single quote and maj, which stands for major, it would say 047. So that would be exactly the same as if I'd done 047. Remember that commas mean have these sub patterns and stack them up so they happen at the same time. So if I do that now, hear the chord. It defaults to C, so that is C major. You can just put single quote match. And that'll do C major. We can put the C in. If I do A major, there you go. So major, C major is notes 0, 4, and 7. A major is 9, 13, and 16. So it's the same major chord. It goes up 4, then up 3. This does the same. 9 plus 4 is 13, plus 3 is 16. It's just transposed up. So there we go. So there's A major. There we go. I've added legato too because super mandolin's quite short. Yeah, it's a synthesizer, but yeah, I find it a bit it's nicer if it's longer, even though mandolins don't actually sound like that. I prefer legato too. Right. So the default is C major. You can choose others, so you can sequence these like as if they were notes. You can put minor if you want, or minor seventh. There's a whole range of different chords you can use. Right. So at this point, you've got enough to participate in the emerging art form of Algoraoke. So Algoraoke is like karaoke, but with algorithms. This isn't the most complicated algorithm, but bear with me. So I went to a good thing, if you want some chords, then a good thing to search for is the ukulele tab, because that normally have some really simple chords. In it. So this one is a song by Radiohead called Creep. I've added some reverb for some reason. I suppose because it's karaoke. So that is that. If I add Q trigger one, which just kind of resets it, so it'll start on the first chord. I'm just going to slow that down a bit. Oh, and here I've just got it with a bit extra stuff. So it's also got some a struct in there, so it's kind of strumming. And I've also got it with a jacks here, so it's reversing it and it's subtracting 12, so it's kind of dropping that octave. This dot is making it so you can do both functions together in one jacks. I'll talk about that in more detail in a future video. I don't actually know the lyrics. I'm a creep. I'm a widow. What the hell am I doing here? I belong here. Yeah, I need more reverb on the mic for this to be authentic. Algoraoke, but you get the idea. So I'd like you to not necessarily sing, but see if you can do a cover version of a cheesy song, and we can all guess what the song is, maybe. Probably 50% of you will choose Blue Monday, so I'm going to just say that for everything, because then I'll probably get half of them right. That's Blue Monday by New Order. It's a good one to try, actually. It's got a nice kick drum pattern. And actually, that kick drum in Blue Monday is the ODX. So, where is it? Oh, there. I forgot that I slowed that down. So it would be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Something like that. Yeah, that sounds pretty authentic. So let's see who can do the version of Blue Monday that is least accurate with the most number of characters. Let's see what you can do. Okay. Yeah, you might be wondering what chords are available. This chord list should tell you, but actually you have to run this line first. I need to fix that. You have to import this library to get the list. But there they are. There's a lot of them. So let's try a couple out. They're pretty exciting ones. And you can... Oh yeah, so if you can look at the raw data to see what they correspond to. So 7 sharp, 5 flat 9 is this series of numbers, and that's all it is. So you could, in fact, do the same with this. I've lost it now. I think it was this one, yeah. So these two things are the same. It's just like a list of numbers that happen at the same time. I put sound by mistake. That should be note or N. And yeah, so this should sound the same. Except I made another mistake. Yeah, I forgot the single quote there. Yeah. Yeah, that sounds different. I must have picked a different sound chord. Never mind. That's not too important. So yeah, it's all numbers. So the other thing is that if you've got a chord of C major, that's got 3 notes in. So C major sounds like that. C major 7th. It's got that extra note in, so that's 4 notes. But you can actually ask Tidal to give you a chord with a certain number of notes in, and it'll just go up the octaves, finding those extra notes for you. So if I just add C major, you can use another single quote. That'll be the same because it's 3. Let's go 4. And kind of here it's layering on top higher notes. Sounds more and more impressive until you start to weep for joy. That becomes really useful in the next section, which is arpeggios. So arpeggio means kind of break up a chord into individual notes. And play them one after the other. So let's do that with the arpeggiate function. You can hear those 3 notes really clearly now. And if I put 4 with a single quote, you can hear it's adding an extra one. And because it's adding an extra one, playing it in the same cycle, it's playing them faster to fit them in. So now I could do every 2 rev to go down again. And if you have a sequence, they'll do the arpeggio thing within their own little step. So you can hear there's 3 notes in C major, 4 in E minor 7th or something. And I can even that up if I wanted by making that 4 as well. So on its own, there were 3 notes here in this half and 4 in this half, and it was a bit uneven, which actually sounds quite nice, but maybe that's not what you're after. So you can even it up like that. So that was arpeggiate, which just simply plays one after the other, going up. There is a little cousin called arp, which lets you tell it different schemes for arpeggiating. So let's try just with this, actually. So if we just put up, this would be the same. If I put down, then it would be like it was reversed, kind of. If I put up, down, it's going up, then down, so lots of notes being played. If I play pinky up, I think by pinky, this is referring to your little finger, and it's as if your thumb is staying in the same place and your pink is moving up the notes. I think that's the idea. So the top notes keeps repeating, but alternating between the lower ones, which are stepping up. Maybe you can just hear that. Yeah, I'm unconvinced by my own explanation there, but you can hear what's happening, hopefully. And you can pattern those, of course. That's interesting because it's playing one chord per cycle, and the first half of the cycle it's playing one arpeggiator style, and the second half it's playing another arpeggiator style. That probably isn't what I meant to do, actually, but it sounds good. Yeah, here's the list. I'd be interested in adding more of these, so if you've got ideas, let me know. And here's a more complicated example. So every cycle it takes a different chord, every cycle it also takes a different arpeggiator function. Well, they're not really functions, but let's call them that for now. But there's actually 4 different chords here, different numbers of notes in. There's 5 different arpeggiators that I'm moving between, so that's different numbers, so that won't repeat until probably 20 cycles, I think. I'm not completely sure about that, but okay, this sounds interesting, and it's always good to have a bit of reverb. And I don't know why I've got a clap there, I was probably just testing something. Okay, so there we go. Thanks for watching. I look forward to hearing some of your cover versions. It's actually quite a nice thing to do, is try and turn a song that you know into a pattern. Try and make it in an interesting way, so you learn about Tidal in the process. It can be quite hard, actually. For example, with this Creep song, the and this is quite common, it'll change the chord part of the way through the kind of bar, which I find quite confusing. And there was a track, I can't remember what it's called. I was trying to transcribe a interesting drum and bass track. I'll have to dig it out. And it took me ages to try and... It sounded like a really weird time signature was going on. And I realised it was just, in the end, really simple. And I was just starting at the wrong point. There was this delay between the start of the cycle and when the first note happened. So sometimes it can be a bit of a puzzle to work out, especially if you don't have any musical training like me, but a real learning experience. Okay, so thanks for watching, and see you soon.